you a bit from the preamble of Resolution 976, which states that the suffering and harm caused to the victims of nuclear weapons in Russia, as well as those affected by the testing of nuclear weapons, is unacceptable, and that New York City has a special responsibility as a site of Manhattan Project activities and nexus for financing nuclear weapons to express solidarity with all victims and communities harmed by nuclear weapons. The legislation garnered a majority of council member co-sponsors, and in 2020 we had an overwhelmingly supportive hearing at City Hall, featuring 5 hours of testimony from diverse communities. Today it only needs Speaker Johnson to allow the legislation to come to the floor for a vote in this City Council session. By helping Resolution 976 and INT 1621 come to a vote, Cory Johnson can join a long tradition of nuclear weapons-free heroes, and New York City can claim its rightful role as a progressive leader, properly honoring the survivors from 76 years ago today. Thank you so much for being with us.
We went to the submarine manufacturing center in Groton, Connecticut, electric boat factory. I boarded with three other friends up a Thames River on a canoe, boarded the USS Florida Trent submarine in construction, and walked up the tail fin, got onto where the head hatches were of the submarine, and with hammers, hard hats on, because we didn't know what we were going to encounter on July the 4th, we hammered on the missile hatches of the USS Florida submarine that eventually went out to water. We were there on board for about 25 to 30 minutes before a Navy man who was on board as security and hooked out the sub saw us, thought we were workers because we had hard hats on. We had to actually explain to the man that we were here for a protest. He laughed, and then we pulled out a banner and said, "Triton is the end of the world." And then he went, "Oh my God, you ruined my watch." He had to go all the way back down to the front of the submarine, which is 2.5 football fields long, and go downstairs and call security and have security come out to pick us up off of the sub. There were four of us there. There were five others, three women and two other men, who were in the south storage yard where the sonar sphere were, and they were hammering on the sonar sphere containers to damage some of them to say, disarmament starts here. This is how disarmament starts. You might know of a friend of mine in Philadelphia, and I'll be back to ending the conversation, Shane Claiborne. He goes around now with a smithy, and they take AR-15s and other guns and other weapons, and they turn them into plowshares. They hammer them into, you know, weapons of soil to create, turn over life, not to take life. And he travels all around the country doing that. He's out of Philadelphia in the Fishtown, Pinkerton area. And so Shane is another person who's good plowshares in his own good way. There have been over 100 plowshares. The most recent one with Martha Hennessy over there. Martha was down in Kings Bay, Georgia, 3 years ago, April 4th of 18. And they went into the Triton submarine base in Kings Bay, Georgia, and entered on their property. They were eventually arrested and tried, and several of them are still in prison right now. Mark Colville in Brooklyn, got Patrick O'Neill out in Ohio, and Claire Grady in Alderson, West Virginia, still doing their time. Thank you very much. I appreciate the opportunity to speak to you, and carry on.